an initiative of the Caribbean Association for Feminist Research and Action, CAFRA, and the Taiwan Technical Mission. The Women's Economic Empowerment Project aims to assist the economic recovery and empowerment of youth and women in the Caribbean post-COVID-19. From October last year, 45 women from St. Lucia and St. Vincent and the Grenadines were trained in garment construction and soap making. Among the women who participated in St. Lucia were those who were either unemployed or women already into small operations which complement the project, like crochet and costume jewelry. 11 of the participants were presented with certificates of proficiency at a special ceremony over the weekend.
Today's graduation ceremony gives us an opportunity to reflect on the training generally, which focused not only on the technical skills, but also on a range of capacity building in marketing, branding, business standards, costing, entrepreneurship, and the list goes on. If you look around at some of the products done by the participants, you will see that this level of empowerment has produced great results. It has enabled all of the graduates to use their new skills to create amazing products for their economic benefit.
A cooperative was formed under the project, where the women work together on contracts for their economic benefit. They have already started producing items under the Beautiful You brand with plans for more manufacturing.
I also heard that some participants have already been approached by small hotels or properties to extend their products into the tourism industry. Through this project, women in the Caribbean region have become resilient economic agents who are able to maximize their resources to pursue and contribute to a more inclusive and equitable economic growth that is essential for overall Caribbean development.
The level of commitment and passion displayed by the women throughout the training made it possible for the participants to take advantage of several additional activities which were not originally envisioned when the project was designed and approved. This includes membership in the St. Lucia Industrial and Small Business Association, SLISBA.
You not only answered the call, you can now continue to do so as great entrepreneurs. Always remember that you are a winner and there is no obstacle that can stand in your way now that you have jumped this hurdle and are qualified to do garment construction and soap making. And you know, the most wonderful thing about this training is that the facilitators were willing to go beyond what they were required to do. And the ladies learned how to do toothpaste, they learned how to do creams, and so many other things. It's just amazing.
The women also benefited from meetings with the private sector, a farmer's market, and a trade mission to Martinique.
We also met many important and valuable business professionals, for example, at the St. Lucia Bureau of Standards and outstanding legal, accounting, and marketing professionals. Wow! This was such an amazing, inspiring journey, one that I am sure each and every one of us will never forget.
As the cooperative expands, it is expected that it will enable the establishment and standardization of a regionally unique and identifiable brand of high-quality garment and soap products recognizable in the world market. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.